Hello guys, welcome back to Black Desert Mobile, a new update review and patch notes. In this update guys, we have ILE Rift, okay, Gear Rushes, okay, some changes to the Gear Rushes improvements, and class balances and new events. So, let's get started guys. What should I start with? Let's check the ILE, okay, first with ILE. Fragments or ILE, some changes to the bosses, to the wall bosses actually. So for that guys, you need to, so what is this guys? So this is a way they added for some of the bosses in the future, for all of them, this ILE thing, okay, it's like some type of improvements in the rewards, but you need guys, you need to complete, okay, a series of quests, okay, so for these three bosses, Nuvir, Karanda and Xark, okay, so let's go and see what quest we have to do. So you can see right here a rift splitting in the world, okay, so this is the series of quests you have to do, this one, and we get really cool rewards. You can complete one time per account, and after you complete this guys, you can do those rift bosses, which is an improvement to the current wall bosses, but only three right now are available. I'm gonna talk more about that. So we get nice rewards, tier of goddess, okay, abyssal crystals, some chakra secret books, oh nice, 50 sorcery roots, lapis lazulis, ILE. What else? Oh, 25 dimensional fragments, 100 root of sorcery. So really nice rewards guys, not bad. 3 chakra secret books, 50 chaos cores, 1000 chaos crystal, the final reward. Not bad guys. So after you complete this, you can when the boss will be available, okay, like these three bosses, you can do them, okay, and you'll get in theory better rewards. And another benefit of this new function, okay, is that you can do them whenever you want, but one time per week. So one time per week guys, so if you don't do them that week, you lose the entries, okay. Also you have to come to do all your extra boss rushes, okay, if you have extra boss rushes, in order to do the this version, this improved version. So make sure you do that. It's sad that you cannot use them after to get the better rewards, but that's what they said. We're gonna read more about it in the patch notes, okay? So should I go now? You know, let's go, and then I'm gonna go through the events, because it's very important to see all the important things about this. This is an important change, I would say. Let's see if they say more about the rewards or other things. So this is ILE Rift, okay, blah blah blah. So in order to open ILE Rift, you can proceed after completing the new story. I told you that story. Adventurers who discovered ILE Rift can challenge to defeat the world bosses Xarka, Karanda and Ver on a separate stage with other characters in the family. Okay, so you can do with your family. This is really cool. In ILE Rift, you can enter to the stage once a week regardless of the wall boss's appearance time. So that means you have the option guys to do whenever that week, whenever you have the time. So they will be stored just for 1 week, okay? So if you forget to do them that week, you lose them, you'll do the next week. In ILE Rift, you can enter the stage once a week regardless, okay, this I already talked. Remaining entry refresh every Monday, see? So if you didn't know, you'll lose them. Adventurers who have discovered ILE Rift will be able to enter the boss only through ILE Rift after that. So if you do this quest, series of quests, you can enter those bosses, those three bosses, they will add more in the future, only through the ILE Rift, okay? So you cannot do the normal, it seems, version. The new story, blah blah blah, will be available after you complete the following requirements. So you need some requirements to complete this new story and unlock the ILE Rift. Achieve one wall boss knowledge over level 60. So just one of the wall bosses needs to be level 30 or higher. Just one. not all. And complete Path of Glory Rift 15, Wave 1, once after the update. Okay, so just, you have to do just those things, okay? Should be doable. The story will open after completing the last quest, okay? Blah, blah, blah. After completing the story, okay, you can complete the individual quest of the world bosses that have achieved knowledge level 30. Okay, so that means each of these bosses, the world bosses, they need level 30. Do I have level 30 on them? I don't even know. Because these are the world bosses, not, yeah. Individual quest exist uniquely for each world boss. So you have, a quest for each of these bosses, world bosses, sorry. And when you complete the quest, you can meet the boss in IR Rift. If the conditions are met, you can accept the quest by selecting the corresponding world boss tab in the blah blah blah. In order to complete the individual quest, you must consume all the number of additional entries of the corresponding world boss. Okay, so if you have extra entries, you need to use them before. But if you haven't used, consume those extra entries, if you didn't open those extra entries, you can enter. Okay, so if you have them stored in your inventory somewhere. Once completing the quest, world boss rushes for the world boss can only be done with characters within the adventure family throughout IR Rift. Okay, so this is like world boss, similar to world boss rushes, but only you cannot save them for as long as you want, only for 1 week. In November 23 update, Sarka, Karanda and Uver will be unlocked first, then the rest of the world bosses will be available sequentially. Target, okay, blah blah blah. Okay. After entering the existing world boss, okay, world bosses, these three, reinforcements will join more quickly than before. Added the Protector of Rift title that can be obtained after completing Path of Glory Rift 15 Wave 1 or greater. Okay, added also Honorable Challenger. Okay, let's see also Guild Rushes update. Okay, so Guild Rushes, this is related to Guild. So they increased, as you can see, they added more bosses for the Guild Rushes. As Guild Rushes Season 4 begins, the following changes has been made. The number of summon stones required to summon the boss has increased, and rewards have increased accordingly. So we get better rewards, but also we need more summon stones. The maximum number of people who can participate in the given rush has increased. Normal boss rush has a total of 5 stages, so 5 difficulties for the normal boss rush. And when the boss is summoned, the next boss will appear randomly. Okay, the boss Kadri Gatekeeper, which normally appears in the 5th stage of normal boss rush, has been changed so that you can meet the boss at all stages of normal boss rushes. Okay, randomly appear bosses are Kadri Gatekeeper, Orgoh the Greedy, and Dim the Tree Spirit. If a certain amount of time is exceeded in the normal boss rush, the Immortal Knights will join and additional damage buff will be applied. So yeah, made changes so that Kadri Magic Tower is not set as the target in the Guild Rush of the boss Kadri Keeper. Okay, so also we have the special boss rush will be expanded for 3 levels, guys. So we have 3 difficulties, not just 1 or 2, I don't know how many we have before. As the boss Blazing Ferid appears in special boss rushes, the stage proceed has been changed. The changes in the number of summon stones used, boss appearance, number of elite tokens used, and max guild members in the new guild rush as follow. Okay so you can see for each level you require more stones. That's before, and now, oh wow, for level 5 stone use 50, guild members 50, before we needed 10. Okay, but hope the rewards are good. For the elite level boss, elite level 3 tokens use 1000 and level 1 200, level 2 600. And guild members 10, 30 and 50, so 50 for the level 3 difficulty. Also guild quest, as you can see, guild quest details and rewards has been changed. Guild quest can be completed 3 times a day as before. All existing guild quest and accepted guild quest has been deleted and the daily guild quest has been reset. As you can see, we have easier to do guild quest, guys. So you have to defeat enemies. Okay? All the new quests to defeat enemies has been added, contribution and blah blah blah. So now it's easier to contribute to your guild, guys, with this. Easier to do, just kill monsters, that's it. Okay. Okay, so some improvements to Nova. Then we're gonna check the events. So Nova, let's see. She has lots of buffs. Now they said she's tankier. Also, she will do more damage and she also will be like, let's say, faster or easier to control. So here you can see everything. You can read. Also, Sage also upgraded auto combat efficiency, fixed the issue of using special collapse in front of monster rather than on the monsters. Phantasm fixes the issue where the screen does not switch after attacking with Phantasm's Dark Cleave. Okay. So I think these are the most important issues. Let's see if there are any changes to the shop and then I'm gonna check the events. Oh, what's this? This is new. Black Friday. Did we have this one? I forgot. No, we did have this one, but I forgot about it. Yeah, we did have this one. I just forgot about it. Lucky Shop, it's the same one. Okay. Okay, same thing. This is still here. Okay, so nothing. As I can see, nothing in there. Let's check the events. So first event that lasts for 2 weeks, guys, is November special relay mission. Okay, so we have to do these missions consecutively. Okay, so like defeat 10,000 enemies. The rewards are good. The final reward is 10,000 virtue tokens. Let's see. Then after that, complete 2 bounty mission, 25,000 chakra dust. Ooh. 5 tangled times, 150 stamina consume. Bounty mission 2 again, 25,000 chapra dust, 1 abyssal accessory again, 25k chapra dust, skill books, tangled time, lots of chapra, 2 abyssal accessories, and the final one. Okay, final one, defeat 10,000 enemies, 10,000 adventure tokens. Then we have camp development support. This is until further notice, so you can do for a long time. So we have to consume stamina up to 1000, should be easy to do. And we get, guys, higher grade resource chest. Receive 1000 of each. 50. So this is 50,000 plus another, that's 150,000 resources of each. This is very nice, guys. And also, large stamina potion 2 and large stamina, extra large, that was extra, and large stamina 3. And camp manager Irene for 3 days. Okay, nice, okay. Next event for 1 week for the guild, complete guild quests. So guild quests, as you saw, they are very easy, just kill monsters. And we get, as you can see, also guild rush, if you complete 1 guild rush. Accessory and ILE fragments 1500, some totems. Black Spirit Race, okay, for 1 week on Wednesday, Thursday, Saturday and Monday from 18 to 23:30. Okay, what are the rewards? I'm not sure, we have to see. I don't really like this event, but hope the rewards are good. Okay, this is still here for another, okay, I can claim this, not yet, for another week, so that's good. This one also is here for another week. This is still here for another week. Okay, just need to claim the rewards. This one for 41 days here, still here. Okay, so there are lots of events that we still have ongoing. So guys, this is okay, this is these are the main things. So let me know what do you think about the update. Hope next we'll get some new content, okay, not just new events. And okay, it's not that bad, but it's not the best for sure. So let me know what you think, and see you soon in another video. Bye guys.